We've already reviewed most of Hisense's ULED TVs for 2021, which is Hisense's name for QLED, but what about the entry-level non-QLED model, the A6G? And how does it perform compared to budget models from other brands? That's what we're going to look at now. Hi, I'm Alex, a tester at RTINGS.com, where we help you find the best products for your needs. In this review of the Hisense A6G, we'll first look at the design and smart features before getting to the individual test results. We'll finish with our verdict and quick comparison with the LG UP7000, which is also a budget TV roughly in the same price range. Before we do any of that, we just need to talk about the various sizes because it's somewhat complicated. We bought the 65-inch model to test, and it's available in other sizes from 43 to 85 inches. But depending on the size, it might be using an IPS or VA panel, and the number of HDMI ports is also different. Our 65-inch model is an IPS panel TV, which means our results are only valid for the 43, 55, and 75-inch models. The other sizes use a VA panel, and we expect them to have better contrast ratio, but worse viewing angles. In Canada, this TV is known as the A68G. There's an international model called the A6GQ that seems to be the same TV, but we're not sure. If you have that TV, let us know in the comments below. With that out of the way, let's look at the design. There's nothing exciting from the front, but it's worth pointing out that the bezels are very thin, especially for a budget model. There are two positions for the feet. We set them up in the wide position, but you can move them closer if you have a smaller TV stand. Both positions raise the TV enough to fit most soundbars. The back is where we start to see the budget side of the TV. There are tracks that look like they could be for cable management, but they don't hold the cables very well, so we're not really sure what they're for. It feels decently well built. There's just some flex on the back panel and a fair amount of wobble. Just like all the Hisense TVs we've reviewed this year, this runs on Android TV. We didn't experience any bugs, and it's fairly easy to use. You get your apps through the Google Play Store like all Android smartphones. The remote is the same one that comes with the U6G, and it has a microphone for voice control through Alexa or Google Assistant. For people who want a quick rundown, here's the deal. The A6G is basically an entry-level budget TV. It's an okay TV overall, and it's best for watching TV shows or for use as a PC monitor. If you're looking for something to watch HDR content, this is not it. Motion handling is also not that great, which might be disappointing to sports fans and gamers. Overall, it's a reasonably good and cheap option if you want to get a TV for a secondary room. Now, let's get to the test results, starting with the contrast. As mentioned earlier, we have the IPS variant, so it doesn't perform all that well when it comes to contrast. This means that black will look gray when viewing in a dark room. This is probably the one aspect that will change the most depending on whether you get the IPS or VA panel variant. We can't speak to the VA panel's performance because we didn't test it, but VA panels tend to perform better in this regard, so you might want to go with the VA variant if you typically watch in a dark room. Also, there's no local dimming to improve the black level, which is expected for a budget TV. The upside of having an IPS panel is the viewing angle. The image remains accurate when you view from the side, which is great for people watching at an angle because of the seating arrangement. One of the biggest downsides of really cheap budget TVs is the screen brightness, and that's still the case here. It's just not very bright, so it's not ideal for rooms with a lot of ambient light. We measured only about 200 nits in real scene, which is not enough to fight glare. On top of that, you might have problems seeing the image if you have lights directly opposite the TV because the reflection is just decent. Unfortunately, it doesn't get any brighter in HDR, whether you're in or out of game mode, so don't get this if you're looking for a good HDR experience. Another reason for not getting this TV for HDR is the color gamut. It has about 80% DCI P3 coverage, which is the color space used in most HDR content, and the color volume is also quite bad because of its incomplete color gamut, low screen brightness, and mediocre contrast. This means that it has trouble displaying really bright and dark colors. Color accuracy is okay out of the box, but this can vary between individual units, so yours might be better or worse. Gradient handling is actually excellent. There's very little banding, and the small amount shouldn't be noticeable in actual content. Gray uniformity is okay. You can see that there are sections of the screen that appear darker than the rest, which can be distracting when watching sports or content with a large area of uniform color. Black uniformity is subpar. Our unit has clouding throughout and some backlight bleed, although this is only noticeable when watching dark scenes in a dark room. Just like color accuracy, uniformity can vary a lot between individual units. And you can, of course, exchange the TV if it's really bad. All right, let's move on to the motion handling. It's a 60 hertz panel and the response time is just okay, so you'll see some ghosting in fast moving scenes. You might also see some image duplication because the backlight always flickers at 180 hertz. The flickering can cause eye strain and headaches for people who are sensitive to it, so just keep that in mind, especially if you plan on using the TV as a PC monitor. There's no black frame insertion or motion interpolation on this TV. Because of the somewhat slow response time, there's no stutter in low frame rate content like movies. As for judder, which looks like a camera stutter and is most noticeable in panning shots, this TV can remove judder from native 24p sources or native apps. This means it cannot remove it from a 60 hertz signal like from a cable box. As mentioned, this is a 60 hertz panel, and there is no variable refresh rate to reduce screen tearing when gaming. Now, despite the slower response time and lack of VRR, the input lag is outstanding, so you can still game on this TV or use it as a PC monitor. If your PC can't reach playable frame rates at 4K, or you need to drop the resolution for some reason, it supports most common resolutions at 60 hertz. You just have to force a custom resolution for 1440p. As for compatibility with the PS5 and Xbox Series X, again, it can only do 4K 60, and there's no VRR. But it does have an auto low latency mode, which is a feature that enables game mode when you launch a game from a compatible device. For inputs, you get four HDMI 2.0, two USBs, digital and analog audio out, a coaxial, an Ethernet, and a composite that requires the adapter. The adapter is included in the box. The 60, 70, and 85-inch models only have three HDMI ports. It only supports ARC, not eARC, over the HDMI 1 port. This means it can still pass audio over HDMI, just not high-quality formats like Dolby Atmos or DTS:X. If you're just using the built-in speakers, unfortunately, they're pretty disappointing. They get loud and deliver dialogues clearly, but they have almost no bass and there's a fair amount of compression at max volume. All right, we've arrived at our verdict. Overall, the Hisense A6G is an okay TV. It's one of those very simple TVs that you get for a bedroom or garage to watch TV shows. For fast content like sports or gaming, the biggest problem is the slow response time and the lack of variable refresh rate support. If you typically watch TV in a dark room, you might want to go with the VA panel variant, but we can't speak to its performance because we didn't test it. One thing's for sure, definitely don't get this for HDR. It's just not made for it. If we compare it to budget TVs that we've tested this year, the LG UP7000 is the closest competitor, at least price-wise. They're very similar overall. The LG gets about 70 nits brighter in SDR and 100 nits brighter in HDR, but it has worse viewing angles than the Hisense. The LG speakers sound better too. If you want a more comprehensive comparison between TVs, you can check out the comparison and table tools on our website. So that's it. What do you think of the Hisense A6G? Will you get it? Let us know below. You can check out all the measurements on our website. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. You can also become an insider on the website for early access to our latest results. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.